Hey everyone, after over 10,000 votes, you chose France. So allow me to welcome you back to Fun with Flags, and today we'll be taking a look at the history and meaning of the French flag. We all know the French flag, it's probably one of the most well-known in the world. The vertical tricolor, blue, white, and red, serving as inspiration for many flags across the world, either through its colors and or shape. But what does the flag mean? And how did France get to this flag? How did they represent themselves throughout history? And what is the origin and meaning of the colors and symbols of this great nation? Today, I thought I would try to answer these questions. But to do that, and you guys know what's coming, we need to travel back in time. It all seems to start in the 10th century AD, with the Kingdom of France. The year was 987, and one of the great powers of Europe and the world had just established itself as an official kingdom. But the traditional state flags didn't appear right from the start. During the early Middle Ages, the Oriflamme, the flag of Saint Denis, was used when the kingdom went into battle. We'll learn more about this in a minute, but a blue-colored flag also seems to have been used a lot. Let's see why. The history of French flags is very much connected to the dynasties that were in control of the kingdom throughout its history, as is the case with pretty much every European kingdom. In 987, the Capetian dynasty, I know I'm mispronouncing it, ruled the land, also known as the House of France. It's a dynasty of Frankish origin, which had a crucial role in the formation of the French state. This was their coat of arms, and as we can see, the blue was very much used, perhaps justifying its association with representing France as a whole, since the dynasty was the ruler of France. We can also see in it three fleurs-de-lis, a symbol which will be present in many French flags to come. The fleur-de-lis is a stylized lily. Many of the Catholic saints of France, especially Saint Joseph, are depicted with the symbol. Since France was historically traditionally Catholic, the symbol was further adopted by its rulers. According to French historian Georges Duby, the three petals in this depiction represent the three medieval social estates, the commoners, the nobility, and the clergy. Eventually, the Capetian dynasty was succeeded by the House of Valois in 1328. But being somewhat descendant or related to the Capetian, their coat of arms maintained the blue color with the three golden fleurs-de-lis. After holding the throne for several centuries, the Valois male line failed, and in the 16th century, the House of Bourbon rose to the throne, keeping the same coat of arms, except a little more exaggerated. What seems to be the case, which again is common, is that the ruling dynasty's coat of arms colors and symbols were made into a flag. The initial simple blue of the 10-12th century was eventually filled with many golden fleurs-de-lis, then only three, perhaps to better mimic the coat of arms, and then reverting to a lot again. This was the case during the Capetian and Valois dynasties, but when the Bourbon became the royal house, they decided on a slight change. The flag became white in its background. Some say the obsession with the white came from Joan of Arc's banner, but I'm not sure if this is true. At some occasions, the flag still displayed in its center the blue coat of arms, but it was mostly just white and gold. But there is one more flag that wasn't an official state flag, if you will, but which was used very much during medieval France, the previously mentioned Oriflamme, the war standard of the French king from 1124 to 1356. It was originally the sacred banner of the Abbey of Saint Denis, a monastery near Paris. When the Oriflamme was raised in battle, for instance during the Hundred Years' War, no prisoners were to be taken until it was lowered. Through this tactic, they hoped to strike fear into the hearts of their enemy. Also, do you know that very unfair joke that since the French kind of partially surrendered one time. People say their flag is a simple white flag. Well, at a specific, very short period in history, it actually seems to have been. This was the flag of the Kingdom of France from 1814 to 1830. A period known as the Bourbon Restoration, also being the naval ensign before 1789. But still, it's an unfair joke since the French were actually one of the most successful and fierce military forces in the world throughout all their history. So let's sum up where we're at this time in history. First, they maybe used a simple blue standard plus the oriflamme. Then, due to the coat of arms of the founding dynasty of France, they officially started using the blue and the golden fleur-de-lis, usually three, to represent the kingdom. With the changes of dynasties, some changes also came to the flag. The number of fleur-de-lis changed from three to many, and the blue background eventually became white, but always maintaining the main symbol and the blue and white colors. It was important that we paused here to catch up because a big event is coming up next, the French Revolution. The year was 1789, and on May 5th, the French estates assembled at Versailles, what is seen by many as the official kickoff point to the revolutionary period. I won't get into the whole revolution story, that calls for its own video, so comment below if you would like to see that. All you need to know is that this was a period of revolt, reform, and deep change in the French state. Overthrowing a monarchy, implementing a republic, an empire with Napoleon, then switching back a bunch of times between republicanism and monarchism before reaching the final and current democratic republic form. But we're here to talk about flags, so let's get back to that. This is the moment when the current French flag was put into use, on the year of 1790. Early in the French Revolution, the Paris militia, which played a big role in the storming of the Bastille, are said to have worn a cockade of blue and red, the city's traditional colors and flag. Remember the original dynasty that sort of formed France? Well, they did it from their original domain of Île-de-France. So it's curious that once again, the local symbols of the region seem to be the origin for a national flag. According to French general Gilbert Dumortier, white was the ancient French color and was added to the militia symbol to create a tricolor. Eventually, these became part of the uniform of the National Guard and were used as the basis for the national tricolor flag. At first, the colors were reversed, being red, white, and blue, only taking the current order in 1794, following the design of a man called Jacques-Louis David. The royal white flag was only used again during the Bourbon Restoration from 1815 to 1830, but the tricolor was brought back after the July Revolution and has been used ever since 1830, besides one brief exception during the Second French Republic when they used this flag, switching the white with the red but then quickly reverting it. Other than that, the only changes have been a few times when the shades of the colors were slightly altered, especially the blue. So now that we've seen the origin, what's the symbolism of the flag? Like I said, blue and red are the traditional colors of Paris, used on the city's coat of arms and flag. Blue is said to be identified with Saint Martin, and red with Saint Denis. Remember the oriflamme flag we saw earlier? The one the medieval kings used in battle? That one was red as well. But like every single flag, there are a lot of different interpretations for the origin and meaning of the colors. Some say blue and red are associated with the Virgin Mary, the patroness of France. Others say white is actually the color, also being associated with Joan of Arc. Some even state that they may also represent the three main estates of the old regime: white for the clergy, red for the nobility, and blue for the bourgeois. But this doesn't really add up. There's also another theory. Lafayette's National Guard used blue and red, then adding the white. The Royalists used the white, sometimes completing it with the three traditional golden flowers. And the Jacobins, another faction in the Revolution, used red. so the gathering of the three colors might be seen as a symbol of moderation. But the official answer of the French government on their website is that the white field was the color of the king, while blue and red were the colors of Paris. The three colors are sometimes associated with the three elements of the revolutionary motto: liberté, freedom, blue, égalité, equality, white, and fraternité, brotherhood, red. So that is the French flag today, a vertical tricolor, blue, white, and red. Like I mentioned at the start, this French flag influenced many flags throughout the world, either through direct conquest, like Napoleon did in Europe, or like they did through their colonial empire, or simply through the fact that the colors and shape symbolize the Republic and values of freedom, equality, and democracy, which other nations liked and wanted to adopt. Examples of this might be, for instance, Ireland, Côte d'Ivoire, Romania, Belgium, Italy, Russia, and many, many more. Inside France, its regions also fly specific flags according to local history, in many cases using the symbols of the royal houses which ruled them during medieval times. We should pay special attention to the region of Île-de-France, the origin point of the Capetian dynasty, which from it founded the Kingdom of France. It still uses today a simple blue flag with the three original fleur-de-lis. Only Occitanie breaks the trend with this flag, breaking what I think is a sacred rule of not having text on a flag. There are also the flags of France's remaining overseas regions and collectivities, like the flag of French Guiana in South America, the flag of New Caledonia, French Polynesia, and the French Antarctic lands. So this was a brief overlook at the history and meaning of the French flag, its origin, evolution, changes and meanings throughout history, from the monarchy blue and white with its medieval symbols to the more recent shape and colors of freedom, equality, and democracy. Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you liked it. If you notice any mistakes or missing information, make sure to leave a comment below. And also leave your suggestions for future flag videos. Remember to subscribe if you want to catch future videos, and I will see you next time for more general knowledge.